Tappy has just released Arc 7 Chapter 58, and this video will be a summary of the chapter. I highly recommend you check out my Arc 7 Chapter 57 summary. Anyways, let's begin. But before I begin, I will not be live streaming today because of this chapter, and today is the 10th anniversary of ReZero. So Tappy has released a lot of new information, which I'll make a video on. Some interesting tidbits is that Emilia and Subaru will get together in a certain route. We don't know what route this is referring to, if this is envy or if it's like lust if. But there is also a route where Emilia and Subaru will have babies together. Not only that, Tappy confirmed that ReZero will have a happy ending. So remember when people said that the ending will be bittersweet? Happy ending, confirmed. I'll make a video on all of the trivia that we learned, but I thought you should know. Also, I'll not be live streaming today, but I highly recommend you go to my community tab and you vote on the sort of questions I should ask, because I'm going to be doing a small quiz when I do live stream. Anyways, let's actually begin. The chapter begins 3 years ago. That was when Tarita was assailed by nightmares about her destiny. This was back when Tarita had nothing to do with a natural destiny or with stargazers. What do people think of when they hear the word destiny? Fate and destiny are unavoidable things which are in your life. Things like death, a fate everyone will face. Hunger, disease, sickness are all inevitable acts of fate which will come. When a fellow Shudrakian dies, they sing and feast to send him off. Tarita believes in those values. Tarita, who was born in the Shudrakian tribe, believed she would live her life with her fellow Shudrakians, from the start to the end of her life. After all, that was her destiny, her fate. Hey Tarita, I was chosen to be a stargazer, and I was given a destiny. Tarita's closest soul sister confided in her. The scene changes and we see Abel overlook the shadows, realizing that the great disaster in front of him is different from the fall of the Empire. With that, he utters that the outsider needs to be removed from the board. Abel steps forward, but Medium grabs the hem of his shirt, stating that Abel does what he wants without explaining what's going on, and Abel blames her for her lack of wisdom. Abel explains that Yorna, Kafma, and the city's people are fighting the shadow, and that the great calamity has a will. Medium was confused. How could the calamity have a will of its own? The disaster chips away at the world. How can it possibly have a will? However, Abel states that it reached out to them. The group was stunned. After all, they understood. The shadows reached out to grab them. In other words, it was reflecting the will of the person who was struggling inside the calamity's stomach. It's reaching out, seeking salvation. Abel spreads his arms and says, "To behold," as the group focus on the disaster covering the Red Rory Castle. The shadows were engulfing everything. However, it was obvious that the arms were targeting Yorna and Lewis. Tarita, watching, is shocked at Lewis's movement and sees Yorna's strength, showing why she's a divine general. With that, Abel showed that it seemed to have a will and explained that Subaru was at the center of the shadows. Abel explains that the mass came from within Subaru, and he knew that Subaru had a secret but didn't know to what it was, and he didn't realize it was to this extent. Medium asks if this is Subaru, and Abel explains that it's something that seems to reflect Subaru's will. Medium asks why Abel feels nonchalant about the situation and explains that it isn't it obvious that Subaru is asking for help. However, Abel states that it will do nothing to solve the situation at the moment, so he's disregarding it. Abel states he needs to speak with Yorna. With that, Abel steps forward, going to the front line to speak to Yorna. Tarita thinks about her role to quell the great disaster. Medium says she will go also. After all, if Subaru is targeting those that he knows, then he will target Medium, meaning that Abel might not get targeted. In other words, Medium will be the bait. Tavrita thinks about it. Medium is a kid, she isn't fast, and if she gets caught and is killed, it will negatively impact the morale of everyone around her. Tarita doesn't want Medium to die, and Tarita likes Medium since she's upbeat and energetic. At that instance, Abel states that Medium's plan is rejected, ironically citing the same reasons that Tarita was just thinking about, the ideas that she could get caught and get killed. However, they were interrupted with someone saying that he will protect Medium. It was Aldebaran, now back to normal, and with his blue dragon sword in hand and a rag covering his face. Ao explained that he met with Olbart, however Olbart didn't want to come to the front lines. Medium asked if Ao is still afraid, and Ao said his fear will most likely never go away. Abel wants to know why Ao is here, after all he was gripped by fear, and if Olbart didn't shake him out of his fear, why has he shown up? Ao states to Abel that he won't explain himself, and that his only master is Priscilla, and that the only reason why he's here is because of Subaru, but Abel can work himself into the plan. Abel asks how Ao will help, and Ao says that it would be a trade secret, but he will protect both Abel and Medium. Abel states that he didn't really consider Aldebaran in his plan, and Ao states that it makes him feel special. Regardless, the three are about to set out, but Abel turns to Tarita and states that she can shoot him in the back with an arrow, but at the end of the day, she will never truly have a choice. As the three walked away, Tarita was there motionless. She didn't have the power to shoot Abel in the back. She had no courage to speak out and express the emotions in her chest. She's just like how she was before, swept away, only to be mocked by the stars. The scene changes and we see Yorna fighting, dodging the black shadow and launching rubble into it. However, the shadow approaches her and she has no chance to react, but Lewis grabs her and warps away, saving her from the destruction. Yorna realizes that Lewis wants to save Subaru, and Lewis nods in agreement. Lewis then warped back up to the top of the Great Disaster. The Great Disaster did not have a head, but Lewis went to where the head would be situated. In doing this, she attracted a larger majority of the Great Disaster's attention, attracting over hundreds of shadow hands. If it wasn't for Lewis acting as a decoy, then the entire city would be overrun by now. Kathma is aiding with his thorns, defending Lewis if needed. We also see Yorna's followers assisting if needed. Only a few minutes have passed since the Great Calamity appeared, however Yorna and the rest were getting tired. However, a shout was heard. A small girl with a barbarian sword entered the fray, alongside a man with a blue dragon sword, one of the messengers who appeared at the castle yesterday. Albeit, he was holding his sword right up to his neck, which seemed to be dangerous as he could accidentally cut off his head if he moved wrong. The shadows attacked Medium, however Ao told her what to do and she avoided the attacks with ease. Yorna was shocked and realized that this was what she experienced yesterday. The masked man told his allies what to do and as a result they dodged fatal attacks. With that, Aldebaran looked up and tells Kathma to spread his thorns in front of him. Kathma wanted to argue, but then the shadows attacked him, and he did what Ao said, barely saving his life by a second, and Kathma asks if he can tell what the disaster will do, and Ao says that he has a bit of a history with it. Ao takes command of Kathma and Medium, and Abel appears stating that Yorna made a fatal mistake, and she should consider his proposal. Abel explains that the Red Rory Castle isn't the symbol of Chaos Flame, and in fact the true symbol of Chaos Flame is Yorna herself. Yona understood what Abel meant, but at the end of the day, Yona couldn't provide shelter and food without having a city. And Abel explains that all of her citizens aren't children. However, a piece of debris hits Abel, knocking off his mask. With this, Vincent Valakia looks at Yona. Abel explains that Yona's will is the will of the people. So if she does not run, then the people of the village will not run. Therefore, he once again states that Yona needs to abandon the city. Abel then points to Yona, asking whether or not she's satisfied with the fact that she cannot defend the city. And he puts his mask back on. Yona asks if abandoning the city will stop the disaster, but Abel says to not test him, and states that the shadow can survive the explosion from the castle itself, but would it survive the explosion from the entire city of Chaos Flame at once? The scene changes. The black eyes overlook the city, which is being destroyed by the great disaster. The shadows consume everything. The city's inhabitants are fighting it, but it will not last long. The threat of the great calamity is too strong. Perhaps this happened before. The people passed down stories of the destruction, the stories passed down by the survivors. The Witch of Envy could be one example of such a story. The false emperor Vincent is flanked by a stargazer who states that the plague that destroys the empire is not the shadows before them. Olbart also appears and Vincent asks where his arm is, and Olbart explains that the shadow swallowed it. Vincent looks at the city and realizes that the plan to defeat the disaster has most likely already been conveyed to Yona. With that, Vincent Valakia states he has his own role to play, and the chapter ends. Okay, so this chapter was kind of meh, but it was extremely weird, like the ending. I'm not too sure exactly when Vincent Valakia says, the fake, this is Chisha Gold, and he goes, I have my own role to play as Emperor. So I'm not sure if he's, I'm not sure what he's referring to here. And at the start, you see Tarita mention a soul sister, and we don't know what that means. Is this referring to Mizelda? What I think is, you remember when Ublik encountered Tarita and said to Tarita that, like, Tarita killed someone? Maybe the person she killed was the soul sister. I'm not too sure, because I have no clue what is being referred to in this sort of prologue section of the chapter. But it looks like they're going to blow up the entire city of Chaos Flame to stop the shadows, which is kind of meh. But yeah, thank you for making it this far if you have, and I'll be doing a live stream in the future. I need to do a video on the question and answers, because there's quite a lot of stuff that came out. So yeah, thank you for listening. I'll see you guys next time.